Hello, it's Jan here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a classic LEGO Space Police set from 1989. It was called Mission Commander, or Space Police Galactic Enforcer, depending upon what region you're from. It came with 478 pieces in 1989. This was from what could be called Space Police 1, the first run of the Space Police theme, when it was still new. So this is the color scheme that was used by all of the sets in that series, and this is the biggest set from that entire series. This was kind of the mothership, the big one, the one to try to save up for the most. I think the top view is the best look for it, because you can see those interesting shapes for the wings, how they kind of pinch in towards the front, and also the front canards. Just a really futuristic, mean looking thing, really, for a good guy ship. It looks really evil, actually. And I like that, because I think bad guy stuff in sci-fi often looks better than good guy stuff. Not always, but often. You can see it's kind of lopsided towards the back. It has a lot more mass at the rear end of this thing, and it actually has a cockpit that's designed to only hold one single minifigure. We'll look at that a little bit more closely. But more interestingly, all the stuff in the middle? Not usable. Look at it from this side. There's no space to put minifigs in there whatsoever, and it's not intended to hold minifigs. It's kind of designed like a major hallway, like a kind of a neck of a spacecraft, but it actually only has one purpose. It's a very cool one, though. Check this out. I'm just turning a knob with my right hand. It's opening up the entire front canopy section, and it's spitting something out, too. Spitting out a little surface vehicle. You actually drive this out. It's a pretty basic looking thing, a little truck, but that's actually where your pilot would sit. Let me go ahead and put one in. See, simple little thing. Just has a couple of control sticks on the sides. Just looks like a little small utility vehicle for moving, kind of shuttling, ferrying cargo around on the ground at a terminal or something. There's actually some cargo on the ship that can be carried by this, but for right now, I just want to show you what it looks like when you put this into the ship with the pilot. Again, turning this knob over on the side. Just got to make sure everything's lined up right. Kind of pulls him up in there. Looks like he got, that actually went down properly, and there you can see him. He gets raised up a little bit and sits right there in the cockpit. You can also open up the main cockpit itself to just put him in directly like that, but it's a lot cooler if you go through the whole process of opening the entire thing up. That whole action is made possible by this old Technic assembly, which has a gear in the middle of it. It's actually a very special, highly specialized, dedicated assembly. The rack piece right here is a separate piece that you can put in and attach things to, but the thing that the knob is attached to is all basically one whole pre-made assembly. There you can see just a little bit better. You've got 1x2s down below, but everything else in the middle, all this black assembly except for the knob there, it's all just pre-built from the factory. Zooming back out and moving back towards the main wings, these are very useful parts here because you have these pods, one on either side, which have these small little spacecraft underneath, just little almost hovercraft little things just for shuttling people around. Got a couple of engines on the back, and again, the dual control stick set up, and that's just it. No weapons, no tractor beams or means of stopping the criminals or anything like that that you're supposed to be going after, since this is all about police. But yeah, you get one of those on either side, so that's cool. You got cannons on the side as well as cannons up front that we saw around the cockpit section. These can actually be turned up, and when you turn them up, it allows you to rotate the wing outward, which unlocks the center section. Here it is on the other side. Turn this up and then rotate the wing outward, and then there's just one single Technic pin that holds this entire rear section onto the whole ship. So let's just drop that off. And this is the main cargo bay. So you can just leave the entire thing off and go flying away if it's going to take some time to transfer cargo out of here. But the question is, what is the cargo? And the answer is a pair of prison cells, laser sealed little cells that are on their sides for holding the bad guys that you're transporting around. You've also got some sort of major sensor up here on the top, which you can turn up and down a little bit. You can also turn it to the sides just a little bit. And then this whole section back here just leaves a little bit of extra space. Most of that space is taken up when you have these in place, but you can also access that from the back by opening this up to just kind of get to this little landing area in the back and just a little bit of room down the middle. The little jail cells are pretty nice. I really like the trans-red windows. Looks really, really cool to me. Got the printed pieces on the sides, the panel pieces, and then the simulated laser beams that are coming down, acting like, you know, laser bars. And you can load the dude up by turning off the laser beams, turning off the laser bars, basically, so that you can then put a guy inside. And we will take a look at the minifigures independently later on. Of course, he's a very happy prisoner. Put that back in, and that's what he would look like in there behind bars. Looks pretty good, you know, fits in well. You can monitor his status, his situation here. I really like this assembly. I also found it interesting how they use these modified plate pieces with the kind of hooks, the bars sticking off the ends to lock each cell into place. One of them goes under the plate piece with the round extension and the hole on the end. The other one goes underneath this 1x4 tile, and it just slides in there and actually locks in quite well, both front and back. These are old pieces, so there's a little bit of flex or warping in them, but that just holds in there very well. It's a very interesting use of pieces for connecting things in non-permanent ways. That same strategy is used to attach the jail cell to the little truck. Just slide those under there, push this forward. There you go, perfect. That looks really good now. It's got just a nice shape to it overall. Makes it really look like it's designed to do this. A little bit heavy in the back. Almost wants to tip back. Not quite though. I like that. The ship, meanwhile, with the cargo section removed entirely, still looks cool. Still looks interesting. Maybe even a little bit more mean looking than before because of just a little bit more insectoid kind of feel back here, I would say. I might want to just leave these up for just a little extra kind of verticality to it, or leave them just at an angle. I think that's how I would do it. Just put them at about a 45 degree angle. I think that's the best look right there. The minifigs in this set consist of two so-called space police officers and then one criminal who's just a Blacktron astronaut. Interestingly, the space police officers are really just Futuron astronauts with red transparent visors, so just a very slight change to their color scheme, and that's it. These are original. These are all correct. I believe they have the correct ages of parts, all of them. They got their black air tanks on the backs, so I'm pretty lucky to have gotten those in pretty good shape like this, although they are used, so they weren't just sitting in a package for all these years. That's a good thing. And yeah, same faces on all these, just the regular smiley faces. Nothing too fancy. I do really like the print on the Blacktron torso, though. So a really cool looking thing with also some very nice action features to it. I definitely like the thing on the whole. It's just really a shame that so much space all through the middle of the main ship is just unusable. The rack and pinion assembly is very nice, and they seem like very useful pieces. I like how that works, but it just wasn't worth so much of the length of the entire ship just to pull off basically lifting the canopy in the front. But now you've seen the set and you've heard my thoughts about it, please share your thoughts in a comment if you like it, if you don't like it, what you think about the whole mechanism in the middle, what you think about the color scheme for Space Police One on the whole, and anything else that you would like to share. I'm going to go build some more stuff so I can bring you even more videos. Thank you very much for your time in watching this. Stay tuned to the blog at JANGBRiCKS.com to see everything that I'm up to in the LEGO world and more. And I'll be talking to you again soon.